Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Normally, I'm in the Christmas room. I'm watching where I step. But you guys that have been around for a while know that I do occasional walks out in the backyard. So this just came in the afternoon, and this is the Sony A74. A7 Mark IV, A7 number 4, whatever you want to put or assign to it. So that's what I've got now going. I just put on my Tamron 17-28 2.8 lens, but I'm letting the camera handle everything, A to Z. I put it in P mode, which P stands for professional, right? That's what I thought, okay. So I could tell you right off the bat, I'm at 17 millimeters, and I left it in standard, okay. So I did go in and turn down, just for safety's sake, the contrast. I turned it down one because I can put the contrast back up again and when I put this into Final Cut Pro. See my new t-shirt? Hi Lillian, thank you so much for this beautiful t-shirt. Let's put it in front instead of on the side. She handmade it just for me, so I want to give a shout out to Lillian. Now let's do some walking around. So first things first, I put this in active stabilization. All right, active stabilization, even though I'm at 17 millimeters on the 17-28 lens, and normally I would want to set this to be going at a small aperture, no, a wide aperture, because I want the blurred background. But with it being in the P mode, I'm not controlling any of that stuff. I'm not controlling the shutter speed, which is a no-no, okay? Since I'm shooting 4K 30p, I should be at a division number of 30, okay? Or a multiple of 30. So I am not at a multiple of 30. I'm actually letting it do what it wants. The aperture, I'm letting it do what it wants. Okay, so I just put myself in the sun there for a second so you can see how the ISO is auto ISO. So let's see what it's got running here. It's running 250th of a second shutter speed at f3.2, not bad. And I can't see anything else, even though I got my glasses on, it's a little too bright. So basically what I want to do is I want to just walk around naturally, and I'm about to enter the grass right now, okay? And my hair is flying up, sorry. Windy outside, cars are going by. So I'm at 17 millimeters, and let's see, what else do I have going on? So let's walk in the grass where I'm uneasy, unsteady, and see what the active stabilization does. This is one of the biggest things that I liked about the little one. What is it, the ZV1. So I'm actually using the handle that goes on the CV1, which is kind of like a stick that sticks out the bottom. I do have a flippy screen on here, so let's change hands again. Ah, camera is a little on the heavy side. Okay, so I'm going to go over here where it's a little more flat land, and I'm going to walk around in the backyard. You're going to get sun in your eyes in a second, because now the camera is actually aiming towards the sun, and I am actually walking, hitting potholes, trying to balance like on a tight wire. I got my arm out. No, I'm just kidding. I'm making a bigger deal out of it than it is. So I'm coming up here to concrete. So now I am on solid concrete and I stopped walking. So I'm actually standing still. So let's take another walk through the garden. We'll call it the garden, okay? So I'm switching hands. I would say the 17 millimeter is actually very nice. I would say the sun in my eyes is not very nice, okay? So, but I am heading towards the sun, and you'll be getting sun in my face, sun in my eyes, and I can't really tell where there's potholes or not. So what's the purpose of this? You know, when you get a new camera, I want to see what it's like. I want to see what it's doing. I want to see, you know, first of all, the active stabilization is supposed to take you up from the Sony stinky stabilization. Okay, sorry Sony. But your stabilization just basically sucks, okay? However, active stabilization changed that. And on the last camera. So I want to see how it is here on this A7 Mark IV. Let's just call it the A7 Mark IV. So I'm still walking in the grass. I'm trying to float the camera, so to speak. The camera's pretty close to my face. So from here, to there, okay? That's the power of a 17 millimeter lens. But the active stabilization is actually cropping a little bit. So it's actually not giving me the full length of this. So I'm gonna set this down now on the garbage can, okay? And I'm going to zoom it in so that I can step back without falling all over myself. And let's get over here. So now the camera is sitting on, you know, those things that you take out to the garbage in the, every, once a week or something, or twice a week, whatever your schedule is in your city. So this is what it, the A7, this is the first thing I'm doing with it. Okay, I did format the camera, okay? I'm sorry, I did format the SD card. I should have formatted the camera. You know, I've been preaching that, and then I didn't do it. When you get a new camera, reset it. Because somebody could have tried to show somebody with the camera, it's still new, and then you get it in with the wrong settings, and you wonder, why doesn't this thing work? What's wrong with it? How come there's something going on, okay? So now I'm using, to give you some of the outlining properties on what's going on, I'm using the Tamron 17 to 28 2.8 lens. I have found it where it gets a thumbs up from me. It's got a excellent quality, as good as if you bought a Sony lens. Now 17 to 28, when you put it at 17 and you've got the active stabilization on, then at that time you get a little bit more cropped. However, because it's 17 millimeters on a full frame, you still get very good for vlogging, okay? So the only thing negative I have is for me, okay, now remember I'm 68 years old, I'm not 18, okay, or 25, so maybe my muscles are not as strong as they were years ago, but I'll just say yes they are, they're even stronger, okay? So that is what we've got going on. Now I'm moving up a little closer and I'm going to make the lens a little bit wider, okay? So now I'm closer to the camera and I'm trying to think of what else I need to tell you. So starting from the top, I'm at in P mode, meaning the camera's handling everything. I am in standard color settings. I did change the contrast and the sharpness down by 1 and 2 respectively. The reasoning for that is because I can control that when I take it into Final Cut Pro. If I want it sharper, I can make it sharper. But I can't successfully reduce the contrast because all the stuff is hard-coded in the movie file. I can manipulate it, but it's better to walk away with something that's a little milder and you pump it up a little bit rather than something that's harsher and you have to pull it down. So that's what I have in the standard mode. Stabilization, you've got the standard, and then you've got something called active, all right? So I set it to active and did the walking around, up and back and forth around the yard. So while I'm still talking to you, this is what it kind of looks like when you're holding the camera instead of aiming it at you, you're aiming it at something else. Now because the lav mic is taped under my shirt, you're still gonna hear me. So I'm just showing you the swimming pool right now, okay? So this is the widest it'll go, okay, the 17 millimeters. And this is the most zoom it'll go. So it isn't like a 28 or 24 to 70, all right? However, you do get the added benefit, blessing, whatever you want to call it. Let's do a wide shot here, okay? So we do have the sun is starting. Let's pop up. Okay, so the camera is actually in, getting a full, let's move over a little bit. I want to see what the sun happens with the sun. Oh, it's behind the trees. Okay. So if I flip this back out to 17, all right, I can just turn this around. So this is what we've got going. This is what it looks like. A74, the maiden voyage. Of course, I'm going to show you inside the Christmas room. We'll do the walk of focus. We'll do the colors, we'll do all the normal kind of stuff that I do inside at the Christmas room. My Christmas room, okay? But right now, this is my backyard, and I have a pool in the backyard, which needs maintaining, which means I have to brush it, sweep it, and skim it, and put chlorine in it, and all that kind of stuff. But since I've just started my keto diet, this pool is going to come in handy for exercise purposes. But if you want to buy a camera and you want to hold onto it for quite a while, and not have to worry too much about some drastic changes. So this does have 4K 60p, but it's going to take you down to Super 35, which is basically the 1.5 crop. But if you plan on shooting in 60p, okay, you'll get the advantage of whatever it is you're using for 60p. Plus, it's got the slow motion effects in it too. All right, I think that's about all I could think of. I'm sure there's going to be something else. I do all the basic stuff, like subscribe, give it a thumbs up, make a comment. Don't just watch. Make a comment. Let me know what you're thinking. I know. I don't want you guys commenting on my hair. Okay, it's blowing in the wind, and we got a pretty nice wind going on. All right, so Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, from the backyard. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.